Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a CV or a resume in Word. So I've just got open an A4 document. If you want to change your document, go to Layout, go to Size, click on the drop down, and then you can select from any of these page sizes. I've clicked on A4. And the next thing we'll do is go back over to Margins, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select Narrow, which gives me a little bit more space to create our resume. My cursor's at the top here. I'm just going to press the Return key a few times. And then I'm going to insert a table. So go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down. I'm going to go down to Insert Table. I need three columns. I'm going to put three in that box there. Number of rows, 30, and press Enter. My rows are quite narrow, so I'm going to select the table by clicking on this square at the top left. I'm going to go to Layout, and I'm going to go along to Height, and I'm going to change the height of these cells to 0.8 and press Enter. But also I'm going to change the alignment. At the moment, you can see all the blue lines are at the top of the cells. I'm going to make sure it's selected, go to Layout, go across to these icons here, and I'm going to select this one, align to center left. So all my text will be aligned over to the center left of these cells. I'm also going to change the alignment of this line here, and I'm going to pull it over to the left. And all this is going to be a dividing space between the information on the left and the information on the right. So now I'm just going to get rid of these border lines. I've selected the table, go to Table Design, go across to Borders, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select No Borders. Now you can see everything disappears. It's going to be really challenging to put the information where we want it. So go back up to Borders and go all the way down to View Grid Lines. And now you can see if I deselect, you can see there's a load of dotted lines outlining each cell. That means that if this was printed, these grid lines wouldn't exist, but it's just there as a guide to ensure that you can see what you're doing. So the first thing we're going to do is put the information into this table. Now I've made this up before, so this is the one that we're actually going to create. So all I'm going to do is copy and paste a lot of this information across, but I'll go through it with you so that you know where you need to put every item. So contact information, let's put at the top. So we just literally go to the top cell. I'm going to paste this in, but you can see on the original here, there's a line underneath it. The way you put those lines in, make sure you're in the cell, go to Layout and go to Table Design and go back over to Borders and click on the drop down. And here you can see you've got all of these bottom borders, top borders, and you can allocate the border line that you want in accordance with the cell that you've clicked on. So for this one, I want a bottom border. So just click on that bottom border and you can see that bottom borders just run along there. You can change the thickness of these border lines with this drop down here. So if you want a slightly thicker line, you can choose additional lines here. And you can change the color. So you can go to pen color and change the color of those border lines if you want to. And you can also change the look of those lines if you want something a bit different. So that's the way you put those lines in. Let's go back over and on here, you can see we've got these little icons. Now, these are all grouped together. So if I just ungroup these, so we're going to go to picture format and I'm going to ungroup them. Now, all of these are icons that you can find in Word. So let's go over to insert icons, click on the icon. And then over here for the first one, let's put in phone. If you put phone into this menu here, you've got a wide selection of phones that you can use. So let's just select this one here, click insert. Now, when you insert something into Word, particularly in a table, it's going to explode everywhere and it just looks awful. But don't panic. Just select the item, right click, go to wrap text, and then go down to in front of text. And then you can just move this anywhere you like now and it won't affect anything, and you can increase or decrease the size of it. So if we go back to the original, you can see that I've put everything on its own line. So if I just select this text, press copy, and I'm just going to paste it into the information here. There we go. Now it has pasted these in as well, but I will show you how to do the icons as well. So let's just put this one back in. There we go. So all you need to do with these is just, let me just zoom in, is just reduce the size of them, and then you can just pop these icon in next to your text. So it's slightly moving here, because I've actually got this connected. So if I deleted that one, I could just pop this one in here and then align it to where I want. So let's just go back, Command or Control Z. So then you just pop all of these in. Let's go to the next batch of information. So we're going to start on this side, and we're going to do that because then we need to sort of level up where we're going to be with the different titles. Now, it's not imperative that they all line up. That's completely up to you, but we're going to see if we can line things up. Now, this one's constructed with a table inside of the table, but that's quite complicated to do and it doesn't always work. So I'm just going to teach you this easier method first. So I'm just going to copy that and paste it into the top here. And then once again, go to layout. And once again, just go to borders. I've already selected the border at the bottom here, so I don't need to go back to the drop down. Just click on that one. You can see the border line comes up there. Now I've left a gap with the next cell. And then what I've done is I've actually merged together one, two, three, five cells. So five rows I've merged together here. You can just about see the points. So what I'm going to do is copy this information. I'm going to leave a gap here and then I'm going to select five rows and then I'm going to go to layout and I'm going to go to merge cells. So now you can see they're merged and you can see that I've copied that text into that box. This doesn't always line up. You can see it doesn't line up with this text here. So I can see if this changes. If I select it, go to layout and go to top left. You can see now I've moved that to the top. It won't line up perfectly with this text here, but that's absolutely fine. So the next thing we're going to do is to leave a couple of cells and go to skills. So we'll copy skills and then we'll leave out this line here, go to skills there. And then again, we'll go to table design and pop in that underline or that line below there. Here again, we'll go to employment history, do exactly the same over here. And then again, put that border line in. So for skills, again, this is all points. So I'm just going to copy and paste all of this across and I'm going to merge together three rows. Again, go to layout, merge, and then copy and paste those in. Now, this bottom one hasn't worked. Now, the reason I've managed to get these points in these markers is because if you type in your word or your sentence, and then you go up to home, and then you go along to this icon here, click on the drop down, and you can select bullet points. I've selected this one, or maybe, yeah, this one here, and you can see it's given it a bullet point. However, it hasn't moved it over to the side here. So what we can do is we can select this row here or this line. You can see at the top we've got these two arrows. I'm just going to move these over to line up with the other text. So next is to put in your employment history, and you may have more or less than this to enter into your CV. But this just gives you an overview of the kind of information that you need to be entering into this section. So I'm just going to select this section here. That's one section. And I'm just going to copy it and then leave a line and then I'm going to paste it and let's see how that comes out. Great. So we've got everything on a separate line and you'll ordinarily be typing this in. But again, these haven't come up into bullet points. So I'm going to select them, go to home and then click on my bullet points. And then I can move these over if I want to, again, by using the arrows at the top here, but I don't have to. And once I've got all the information in, I can simply copy and paste that again. So I can copy this, Command or Control C, and then paste it all in. But let's just move that up a line. There we go. And we can do that again. Just paste, select these three lines, and then I'm going to go to my bullet points, and then again to my bullet points. But you can press a bullet point and then start typing. And then again, I'm going to move these over. Move these over here. Okay, so the next thing is honors and awards. Let's go and place that in about here. Again, go up to table design and the line we'll put in again below there. Now for this one, let's select these two here and we're going to copy them and then paste them in. So this has slightly adjusted the gap. So what this has done is this height of this cell here is different to the height of this cell here. Now again, that's absolutely fine if that's what you want, but if you don't want that and you want it to be the same, this one's adjusted as well, you can see the height of that one is adjusted. You can reduce the size of the text, or you can change the configuration of this text within here. So if you wanted to, you could maybe put this information here if you wanted to, or let's show you in this one, we could go to the Home tab and press the Reduce Font Size tool, decrease font size, and you can decrease that font size, but obviously that doesn't make it particularly readable. So let's just go with this for the time being, and it just allows you to see those in there. So let's just adjust this one here and put that on 2 lines and just keep everything in line to look nice and ordered. And then we're going to go along to interests here, put that one there, then go back to table design and put the line in, and then we've got swimming and reading, whoops, there we go, and then education at the bottom here, that we could line up with our references. So if references go here, let's just put education here. We may not be able to fit all the education in actually, so let's put education there. There we go, and then let's put that borderline in there, and then let's just copy and paste this in. There we go. And we'll do the same with here, the references. So if we put references in there, and then put a borderline in there. Okay, so far this is what we have, and you can see it's all been knocked over to the next page. So first of all, we can get rid of these two cells, just select them, sorry, these two rows, right click, go to delete cells, shift cells left, just click OK, and then we can possibly move something up. So okay, so we still got these two pages, so we need to adjust the margins a little bit further. So go over to your rulers. If you can't see rulers, go to view and then select ruler, hover between the gray and the white, you'll see your cursor changes, and click and pull down, and eventually you will get everything onto one page. But again, this all depends on how much information you've actually got to put in the CV altogether. This is just a guide for you to put in what is basically required in a resume. So once you're happy with the information in it, you can select it, go over to table design, go to borders, click on the drop down, and you can deselect view grid lines, and then you can have a look at how that looks so far and if you're happy with it. And if you are, let's just put the grid lines back in. And now we just need to put in the title at the top here, the image, and this gray section. So let's put in the title. So go to insert text box, click on the drop down and select draw text box, click and draw out a text box. There we go. And you can see my cursor's inside. So you need to insert your information here. I'm going to paste it all in. There we go. And then I can put that anywhere I like. Now, when I deselect it, you can see the name is actually inside a box with a border. If we want to get rid of that border, just select it, go to Shape Format, over to here, which is Shape Outline, click on the drop down and just simply select No Outline, and then deselect it. Then we're going to go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down, and then click on a shape. We're going to go for the rectangle, and then just click and drag out a rectangle. And then we're going to change the borderline and fill color. You can't see the borderline, but there is one. Select it, go to Shape Format, go to Outline and select No Outline, and then go to Shape Fill and then select a nice gray color. And then you can see it's covering everything up at the moment. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to Send Backwards, click on the drop down and select Send to Back, and go to Wrap Text and then select Behind Text. Now you can move this anywhere you want to. It's completely up to you. And then the final thing is to put your photo in. So I'll show you how to crop your photo into a circle. So go to Insert, Picture. If things are grayed out when you click on them, it's because you've got the table selected. So deselect, just click anywhere around here, the borders and things. Just click to the side and you'll deselect the table. You know it's selected because this little square shows at the top there. So just deselect it. There we go. Go to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down, select Picture from File, select the picture of your choice and select Insert. Now, it's made a complete mess, but don't worry, we'll sort this out. So at the moment, my picture is a rectangle. If you want this into a circle, you're going to have to crop it to a square, which is really easy to do. Select it, go to picture format, go to crop, click on the drop down, and go to aspect ratio, and go to 1:1. So now you're given these black markers. This is your 1:1 ratio. Just click and pull the photograph to where you want it in that square. Once you're happy, just press enter. Then go to crop, crop to shape, and then go to circle. The reason we didn't crop to circle first is because it's a rectangle, it would have cropped it to an oval because it's a rectangle, not a square. Once you've done that, just click and drag. Because you can't move it, you need to right click on it, go to wrap text and select in front of text. And now you can move that anywhere you want to and make this as big or as small as you want to or need to. Now you can see we might need to push things down a little bit. So let's just pop our cursor here, press the return key. We've made an extra page. So let's try and reduce these margins at the bottom a little bit more. There we go. And then we can just pop this photo here. Now, if this still is too much and you're trying to squeeze everything on, again, you can reduce the size of the text if you want to, or you can just simply eliminate some of these rows and cells, the empty ones. So let's just go ahead and get rid of this one here. Select it, right click, delete cells, click OK. And let's delete this one here, right click, delete cells, click OK. And then we'll give ourselves a bit of extra room at the top here. And then we can move the photo down a little bit and also move the name down. Perfect. So when you're happy, let's just select the table. Let's go to table design, click on borders and select no borders. Sorry, click on borders and go down and deselect view grid lines. Perfect. Now, once you're happy with this, you can do a couple of things. You can save this as a Word document. You can save it as a template and you can save it as a PDF. So to do all of those options, if you go to File, you can either save as a template. That will mean that it will save to your Word software. So when you open a document, you've got templates and you can open this and change it over and over again. But your original will never be affected. It'll always be there in templates. Or you can go to Save As, and then here you're saving it as a Word document and you can see file format here, Word document. Or you can click on the drop down and save it as a PDF. And then don't forget to change it to whatever you want. And then you can simply save it wherever you want to. I'll save mine to my desktop and then just click save. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.